Well, there's a warning tonight. A massive increase in mining will be needed to reach the government's target of cutting greenhouse gases by 43% by 2030. And a major union says Australia is not doing enough to secure the critical minerals it will need to manufacture green technology.
Wind turbines, solar panels, batteries and electric cars. The green revolution runs on blue-collar jobs.
So if we think into the future, we'll have more electric cars, we'll have more batteries, we'll have more solar panels, and all of these need critical minerals and rare earths to make them.
I think the reality has just started to hit that we will need to see many more mines if we're going to make the transformation to net zero emissions by 2050.
And staggering amounts of them. An International Energy Agency report says an electric car needs 6 times the minerals of a conventional car. An onshore wind plant needs 9 times more minerals than a gas-fired plant. So it projects demand for lithium will grow 40-fold by 2040. Graphite, cobalt and nickel demand will rise 20-fold and demand for copper will double.
We're under-investing, under-exploring in copper. That's where we need to do more of the work if we are going to electrify at a global level.
The Australian Workers Union says this nation's critical resources must be secured to drive green manufacturing here.
And these are fiercely fought for right around the world, except that in Australia we're not doing a great deal to make sure they remain on our shores.
Billions will need to be rapidly invested in mining, billions more in transforming electricity generation, and rapidly retooling the grid around renewables raises other thorny questions.
Where the workers are going to come from, how many engineers will we need, how much will it actually cost, and who will pay for it?
Is it solvable? Yes, but boy, it's going to take a significant challenge, and we need to mobilise the activities to bring that together.
And time is short. Chris Yorman, Nine News.